mean, look at it from the tie's point of view, poor bugger. Stuck in a drawer with 7-odd cufflinks, 1 mouldy sock, and a dead nasal inhaler. Unloved and unwanted. And all of a sudden it gets yanked out and twisted round a scraggy neck. What sort of life is that? Mind you, suppose it's worse for a jock to that. Diana, you're not laughing. Crack my best joke of the morning, best joke of the week. Diana.
Jesus! Go! Wake up, Diana! Wake up, Diana! Wake up! Come on! Wake up! Don't wake up and look your senses. You all right?
Yeah. Yeah. Did a blackout.
Yeah. I mean, you're in the bath, not too clever. You all right?
Yeah. I'm in the right pig's ear of your time.
Heads I win, tails you lose.
That never works.
Did the first time.
Yeah, but I'm older now and wiser.
Older, certainly.
But can we get this over with? The tension's bloody killing me.
Heads. Where's it gone?
You're a terrible tosser, you. Where is it?
Oh, well, you would have lost anyway. Come on, hand it over.
If that's landed tails, I'm going to bloody...
I love sherbet lemons. I really, really do.
Hey, they're playing my song. Turn it up.
And whatever I do, I seem to spend all of my time trying to turn my black nights blue. When I'm tired of it all, it's the same thing every night. But the rhythm of glass is stronger than the rhythm of life. My night is like love. I've gone and done it again. Why?
Trust you. You get up and start singing the bugger.
Think many people will come?
Not with your voice.
Name?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Hello, Mrs. Longdon. How are you keeping?
Oh, terrific, thanks. As long as you've got your health.
That's the spirit. Now, 4 appointments again. I'll give you a shout.
Oh, Derek, my file. One of the great mysteries of our time.
Don't even ask Mrs. Longdon. The answer's no.
One quick pee.
Like it always, no.
Just while we're waiting.
It's not hers. It's her consultant's.
What's she doing with her name on then? Going to a fancy dress party?
Tell you what, I'll nick behind the counter, expose myself, create a diversion while you nick your file.
We need a bigger diversion than that, love.
Thanks. I'll tell you something, Diana.
Whoever these fit marries Prince Charming.
No.
Oh, then.
This is going to hurt you more than it hurts me.
Oh, thanks, Fred.
They're a sod to get on, but at least with these you'll be able to move your fingers. Just wear the flat ones at night, and if you have a bad day.
Oh, God. Oh,
sorry, love. I told you.
Dinah, wake up! Dallas is coming on. Dinah! She has another. Dinah!
What are they?
You tell us.
Sorry, Mum. Did it again, didn't I?
Hey, brilliant! Well, perhaps it's with coming in here. People sometimes get a bit anxious.
No, love. Takes her 2 days in bed to gather the strength to come here and 3 days in bed to recover. She isn't anxious. This is her at her best.
We would have to sleep if to get a cup of tea round here.
What's wrong with you then?
Gerald, behave. I'm having my hands mended.
You don't have a bushy as you've got funny hands.
Gerald. No, but I've got funny legs as well.
You look all right to me.
Thank you, Gerald.
What's the race? Gerald! Hold it!
Perhaps I should expose myself while you nick the file.
Be with you in a sec, Mr. Longdon. Just skimming through. I'm filling in for Mr. Loftus today.
Oh, are you sure Mr. Loftus still works here?
Oh, I'm sorry. What was that?
It was my wife who spoke, Doctor.
Uh-huh. And, what did she say?
The medical gentleman who's never seen your file would like to know what you said, love.
Oh. Well, only that I've been coming here once every 3 months for the last 3 years, and it'd be nice to see a consultant just once. If only to prove that they didn't all go down on the Titanic.
Uh-huh. Good. Good. Been seen by 3 hospitals, no less. This and 2 in London.
3 in London. Let me save you a bit of time, Doctor. 5 years ago, I got the flu. Or it was what we thought was the flu. The flu got better and I got worse.
Then came the pain. First her arms, then her legs, then everywhere. Her hands began to bunch up.
Yeah, and into claws.
And bend in on themselves.
Well, I have to wear these bloody things. In a couple of weeks, these will buckle and snap under the strain. A bit like I'd like to do.
A few months ago, she had a biopsy just down the corridor here. She walked in, they cut a slice of muscle from her leg, and she's never walked since. Apparently, it's nothing to do with the biopsy.
I said to them, well, what's it to do with them? They said they didn't know. I said, well, how can you say it's not to do with the biopsy?
Every day she's more exhausted, more paralysed.
Well, yeah, some days I'm better than others.
She has more and more pain, more and more blackouts. All we want to know is what's wrong with her.
And what's in that file? You've had 3 years to find out.
Right. Tell me, how are her periods?
Home time.
Home time.
How are her periods?
Get it.
Bloody moron.
You're supposed to say forget what, you know, like you've already forgotten it. Oh, take the notice. What are you doing?
Any of you ladies fancy a bit on the quiet? Take down that corridor, going spare.
Anna! Why do you never stick them through the letterbox like other postmen?
Card a bit late, must have just got yours. She magazine, returning your manuscript. Another rejection, no doubt. Still save you a bit on toilet paper. Do you get it? Another card. Invitation, I think. You know what I'm here, I don't mind. How's Diana?
You know. Morning.
Nice weekend, Nick.
He's had a nice weekend. Greetings from Morecambe. Love, Nick and Joanne. Joanne, went with the Henshaw last, did you?
It's all right, her mother knows. You don't have to go round and tell her.
Hang on. How's this got here before he has?
He posts them before he goes.
Lateral thinking.
Saves time at the weekend, does it, lad?
Well, why don't you go and get your leg bitten off? Like a proper postman.
Merry Christmas, Nick.
Merry Christmas.
So what else did you do? No one sits in the pictures for 2 days and three nights.
Oh, ignore him, Nick. When we had dirty weekends, we didn't go to the pictures either. Better at pulling them off, aren't you, love?
I hope so.
Right, I'll have my white blouse and my grey skirt next, please, love. Oh, very organised. And I'll need my knitted waistcoat. It's in the bottom right-hand drawer. Thanks, love. What's that?
Ah. It's that bikini you've never worn. Bought at Kendall's just before you took ill.
I'll give it a go in the bath one day. Crack on, it's the Bahamas. Derek, love, this invitation, you should go. It's a literary lunch.
I have an official announcement. We're getting married.
Hey! Not a rush job, is it?
Oh, that'll be for me. I'm plugging the Cortina. I'll take it downstairs.
When's the big day?
I haven't decided yet. I'm still establishing the principle.
Well, can't be a rush job then, can it?
Hello? Hello? No one there. Must be Grandma.
Hello? Hello?
Who's that calling, please?
Hi, Grandma.
Oh, it's your nephew. Whiskey's just asked for some more sugar on his pilchards.
You're quite right, too. It's me now.
Oh, now it's your brother. Hey, guess who popped his clogs? Arthur Askey.
Grace Kelly, and then him. I like Grace Kelly. What did you want, anyway?
Nothing. You rang me.
Well, if it's to say you're going to the factory today, could you call and get my prescription from Dr. Shaw's and take it to a chemist for me?
I'm not going to the factory.
Well, on your way back, then.
So all in hand, washing machine on, ironing when I get back, thermos flask, sandwiches, the world's thinnest turkey defrosting.
See you later.
Bye, love.
Hang on, Nick, you're on my list. Can you pick us up a couple of pounds of sprouts and a jar of pickled walnuts?
We don't like pickled walnuts. No one ever eats them.
That's not the point.
It's Christmas. We don't like sprouts either.
Right.
I hope it's soon.
Hmm?
The wedding. Well, I want to be there, don't I?
Of course you'll be there.
I'll have to buy a hat. I haven't worn a hat since our honeymoon.
Hat? I remember black suspenders.
Oh, go on. Bugger off to your factory.
You'll stay in bed?
Yeah, promise. Unless I get the urge to climb up on the roof and repoint the chimney. Derek, if I am there, I'm going to walk down the aisle, aren't I?
Of course you are.
Crawling on your hands and knees counts as walking, don't it?
I'll see you later. Morning, ladies. Morning, girls. Morning. Oh, God.
And Dad,
Christmas bonus.
Don't know what day it is, Ronnie. I'm renowned for it. Why do you think I've come in? I'm on the way to the bank.
Don't say we're tired of that. It's got nothing to live for.
I'm popping the office, Joan. You too, Sheila. Well, don't just stand there like you've got so little to do.
I wish we were that busy.
I thought we had 50 dozen waistlets on the go.
That was a fortnight ago, love.
Was it?
What are you smoking, that?
Three nuns.
Well, I thought one of them's just farted. Put it out, Derek. Never fools anyone, anyway.
I'll phone Henry Margolis in Bradford. He may want something for his January sales.
Well, there's nothing to make it out of, even if he does.
Isn't there?
We haven't got enough stock to make a bloody shoulder strap.
You're never here to order it, Zombie. If you're never here, how is she, by the way?
I'd best get that machine fixed.
What for?
Derek, this place is losing you 200 a week. That's over 10,000 a year. It's in arrears to the Inland Revenue and Customs and Excise. And it's running a bank overdraft.
Yes, well, no point being realistic, Joan.
How's your magazine writing going?
It's got a couple of things in the pipeline, but I haven't really heard anything back yet.
Derek, they don't pay enough to keep kojacking haircuts. That was her joke, not mine.
What's up? This can all be put right in one fell swoop, and you know that.
And you know me, so forget your fell swoop, Sheila.
It's your only option, lad. If you were here full-time, you could pay someone to look after her full-time.
And that's not just us talking. That's Mr. Tillotson at the bank, everybody.
It's the best thing for both of you. It's a question of priorities.
Exactly. So I'll fix that machine, nip to the bank, and then get straight back to her.
I'll go to the bank. Mr. Tillotson's less likely to hit a woman. You phone Mr. Margolis, Sheila.
In my book, you're a gentleman.
Hello, Karen. What? What who says?
Nursing poor Mrs. Longdon day and night. Standing by her. I mean, it's an example to the youth of today, that, isn't it? I mean, it's unusual, even if the wife's, you know, normal. And can have a, well, normal, healthy, married life kind of thing. I respect that in a man. Staying faithful and that in spite of. Well, you know what I mean?
I think a brick wall would know what you mean, Karen.
Puffed her.
Make sure the roots are healthy. Oh, it's just the leaves that are a bit off colour, that's all. You know what they say? You are nearer to God in a garden than you are anywhere where you are not in a garden. That was just a phone. Direct for inquiries, what town?
Mum, me. These sleeping pills I have to get. Sure? Do you know what strength they are?
I know what colour. Pink.
May I?
You'd make me a very happy man.
The doctor didn't write it on the prescription, you see. And he's not there now, and I can't dispense them unless I know the strength.
Well, you don't have to worry, Chuck. I never take them anyway.
Don't tell me. Nothing she says surprises me.
According to my records, you've had 60 Sonoril tablets a month for the past 5 years.
Correct. Nellie Elliott sucks most of them, and Mrs. Next Door sometimes bothers a few when the sisters had a bad night with the chickens.
I can't let you have Mrs. Longdon. Not till it's sorted with your doctor.
You don't have to keep calling me Mrs. Longdon, Derek. You don't sound much like Derek. Are you an obscene phone call?
Everything's okay, it's all right.
It's only me, love. I suppose Henry Margolis phoned, did he?
Don't panic.
Shit! My God, love, what happened?
Better call an ambulance, love. I think I've laddered me tight.
Love.
Hello? Who's on duty tonight, please? Oh, well, could I speak to Ian or John then, please? Thanks. Hello, Ian. It's Diana.
Hi, sis.
Hiya.
Happy what's it, or not, as case may be.
How is the baby now?
Two fractured ribs, internal bruising, black eye, throwing up all the time.
Jesus, God.
How was Strain?
Christmas Eve. Would have been quicker by rain, dear.
Dad'll be back in about an hour. We're taking in shifts through the night.
Will you skedaddle? Get a night's sleep, the pair of you. Hey, no more than three tangerines in my stocking.
She's in Stafford Cripps Ward.
Oh, bloody hell, she must be bad.
I know, but all I'm saying is, I've done what you said last time. I've had second thoughts. The only trouble is I've had third, fourth and fifth ones. And I'm back where I started, thinking it'd be for the best. For everyone. God, I know. And I love them too. But it's wrong for one life to muck up three. Without me, they'd be able to...
Hello, Great Banana. Bloody thing, I knocked it off trying to get me Lucas, eh? Hello, sad love. Well, here I am again.
It's that boiled cod, isn't it? Can't keep away, can you?
Ooh.
These are foxes.
Yeah.
I don't like fox hunting.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas, Derek.
Hello, Kenneth. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. London.
And to you, Lawrence.
It's not Lawrence, it's Kenneth.
Well, I knew it was someone of Arabia.
Right.
How are you coping?
Fine.
How's the factory? Slow?
On a good week. I'm thinking of turning it into a registered charity.
I've been saving your pocket money since you got married, so you've only to ask.
I wish I had a mum like you.
Excuse me, the doctor's still doing his rounds.
That's all right, Chuck. He won't bother me. Also, it must be 15 years.
18? Arthur's been dead 18 years this week. It was at the funeral.
That's right. How is Arthur?
Still dead.
Poor David Niven's popped his clogs. First Gloria Swanson, then him. If it isn't someone, it's someone else.
They've done some more tests.
And?
I'm beginning to feel sorry for them. Sally asleep.
With all her old teddy bears. They're coming over after lunch with the pickled walnuts.
Oh, great. She's become a croupier.
Yeah.
I always thought she was beauty therapist.
Me too.
I think she's in love. At last.
She keeps smiling to herself in the mirror.
You look like I feel love.
It's just that I've not done my makeup, that's all.
Nurse says they're not going to bother with any more tests. There's no more been invented. Hello.
Hello, love. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
A Merry Christmas.
Thanks for coming.
Oh, don't be silly. It helps to pass the time. I brought you a bottle of ginger ale, but I've given it to Minnie Bonsall. I don't think she's quite with us.
She's knitting a dishcloth.
You want to keep your eye on that girl. That fall was more serious than they think. She sits up very peculiar. And there's another thing. You want to watch her eyes. Her eyes tell you so much more than she does. Or is it just me being silly?
No, Mum. You're not being silly.
I'd rather you didn't. She must be the most written about woman in history, apart from Joan Collins.
Where is she?
You are an anxious husband, aren't you, Mr. Longdon?
You still haven't bloody told me.
Oh, goodness me. Nurse is bringing her.
Good. Thank you. Because if she is, she'll have to be careful dressing her.
I was wrong. Not an anxious husband. An over-anxious one.
Just getting a sleeve on can break a finger.
Tell me, how do you manage without sex? I just wondered if it contributed to your anxiety. A, a lot. B, a little.
C, not at all. We do have sex.
How?
Well, I'm a man, you see, and I was born with what we men call a penis, whereas women...
Mr. Longdon, it's a perfectly valid question for a consultant to ask.
Oh, I must tell Karen, a girl in my factory. She'd qualify as a consultant in 2 minutes.
Some of our specialists suggest that your attitude to the patient might be making her worse. Your stress exacerbates hers, and her stress could well be the cause. Come in.
Hello, love.
Thank you, nurse. What's the matter?
Dr. Roper thinks you're suffering from me. Acute derricitis. Apparently I make you worse.
Oh, come on, love, before I throw up. He keeps me alive and sane and a human being. And he's the only one that does.
Mrs. Longdon, all our specialists agree that you ought to let the Maudsley Clinic in London do some tests.
What do they say is wrong with me?
The report's long. It's very complicated.
And says what?
Hysteria.
It's all in the mind. They're wrong.
Come on, love, let's go home. Crack open a tea bag.
If the Maudsley Clinic reads that it's hysteria, I'm finished before I start, aren't I? Aren't I? Well, aren't I, woman?
Please don't get hysterical. It's professionally unethical for me to remove a colleague's conclusion from a patient's file.
Home time?
Home time.
Perhaps you can do me a favour. Would you drop this in reception for me on your way out. It's, the first 5 pages.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Pain?
Only from reading this bloody lot. If I'd wanted Dante's Inferno, I could have got it out that library. 5 whole pages. And all it says is no idea, no cure, no hope. How's your article going?
Fine. Very good. Damn, somebody rang. Margaret rang. She's coming around to be here about 4. Sally! Phone!
Help me, Steve! Help me, Steve!
If that's the man who worships the air I walk on, hello, lover. If there's anybody else, you can go and get...
Is that Sally? Sheila at the factory. It was your dad I was after. Shouldn't that be the ground that you walk on, or am I old-fashioned? I see. Oh, well, it's nice to be happy. No, but give him a message, if you will. Okay. Ask him, what does he want first, the good news or the bad?
You call, madam.
The VAT want to inspect your books on the 27th, 11 o'clock. Can I pencil it in?
Yes. Can I go now, please? It's a very big order with a lot...
It's not how big it is, lad. It's how fast he wants the bugger delivered.
Exactly. So would you excuse me?
Isn't Mr. Margolis's fault?
I never said it was.
He's only ordered it out of pity. You should have wangled it out of him months back. Then we shouldn't all have his knickers in a twist.
You trying to make me feel better?
No.
Good. You've succeeded. I was wrong about the 27th. I'm out of action on the 27th. Literary luncheon.
Nick! Dad, we got any black shoe polish? But where do we keep it?
You've never polished your shoes in your life. Your mum's been begging you for 19 years.
She's been begging you longer. I need it fast, Dad. Where is it?
How would I know? What the hell's brought this on? You're not getting married today, are you?
We are fixed today, by the way.
Hey, when?
Good lad. Well done.
Funny?
That's it.
What's what?
I remember it. The day I joined the Scouts. Mum polished them for me.
Oh. When's the wedding, then? Okay.
Chance to plug in the car, you see. It's a trick of the trade. You polish the gasket on the rocker cover. Clean engine, quick sale. Hi, Sal.
Thanks for looking great, Pilly.
They finally picked a day, it seems.
Well, when? Dad, when is it?
You didn't say.
You what? Nick!
Nick! Have you got any more hidden?
No, love.
You always said if it came to... You said it wouldn't be behind my back.
It won't. It wouldn't. You'd be the first to know.
You weren't daft, were you? The one place we'd never look.
Clever, these Chinese.
Where were they?
In the shoop. You have got more hidden.
Oops. Not so bloody clever.
Where, Dinah? Tell me.
Oh, Derek, love, you always, always understand everything so well. Except for one thing.
Dinah, where have you put them?
It's the one thing I want to be able to do on my own.
Well, I don't. I bloody don't.
Well, that's got sod all to do with it.
We haven't to give up, Dinah. Ever.
If I want to, Derek, yes. If I decide.
Well, that's why it's not up to you, can't you see? For that very reason.
No, that's why it has to be. For that same, self-same bloody, bloody reason.
March 24th, official wedding bells.
Hey.
I was gonna tell them.
What's wrong?
March 24th, eh?
What's happened?
What are you going to tell us, you bugger? March 25th.
Which church?
St. Luke's.
How long's the aisle?
What?
Get me up, love. Come on, I've got to start practising.
Practising what?
Walking.
Right.
You ain't done that.
That's the spirit. More the spirit.
Yeah, for me, though, that's why I'm your own boss. Because of what I want.
What are you two on about?
I don't wear body stockings.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realise you were a man.
Ladies and gentlemen, luncheon is served.
Derek Longdon.
Lovely to meet you. I'm Aileen Armitage.
Well, you're Aileen Armitage?
I'm a novelist.
No, you're not. You're a bloody wonderful novelist.
I think I'm going to like you, Mr. Longdon.
I'm sorry if it tastes cold, but it weren't all that up when they dolloped it out. Oh, you have to forgive them. It's the pressure. The chef. He has to open more than once, and if anything, he goes to pieces. Well, they said it's mushroom. I don't take bets. Oh, I like your frock.
Thank you.
Which is yours?
Which what?
Which belly?
This one.
Oh, I've seen worse. Reminds me of your dad. Your dad's white. You wouldn't think so to look at me, would you?
Wouldn't I?
Well, bon appetit. Get plenty of bread rolls down here. I like the taste.
Who was that, the waitress?
How do you mean?
She sounded nice. Is there an ashtray?
One ashtray.
Oh, sorry about that.
Didn't you see it?
No, I can't see anything. Well, in a good light, I can see sort of blobs instead of faces. Yours seems quite a nice blob.
One step up.
Are you sure it's on your way home, Harrogate?
I'm absolutely certain. Mind you, I have no sense of direction. Here we are. In you go. It's a Rolls Royce, by the way. Pink.
lying long that it doesn't feel pink. It doesn't feel like a Rolls Royce either.
I'll give it a push, show it who's boss.
Shall I steer?
Steer?
You have to treat unsighted people as though they're normal, Mr. Longdon. Otherwise, we have this tendency to turn violent and call out of the window that we're being raped. It's up to you.
Go on then. It's in neutral and the ignition's on. All right.
No, no, don't!
Tell her to look where she's going!
Blind!
Blind?
Pull the wheel to the left! Brake! Brake now! Brake hard!
See? Told you I could steer.
Service with a smile.
Are you smiling?
Can't you tell?
Hang on. Funny nose.
You're not very good at this, are you?
Handy.
Not very good at all.
Sexy mouth.
Oh, you're improving.
Deep laugh lines, that's what matters.
Do you mean wrinkles? Come on.
Well... Thanks for the lift.
My pleasure. It's done wonders for my laugh line.
And you've got my phone number in case you do fancy writing something together.
Yes, and you memorise mine?
Yes.
You sure?
Well, put it this way. If you get a call asking me to come and mend a tumble dryer, you'll know I've got it wrong. Well... It was smashing to meet you, Mr. Long.
And you, Mrs. Armitage.
So, I'll love you and leave you.
Can you manage?
I have till now.
No, no, I meant for the flat.
Yeah, I know you did. See you.
See you. Illness and so forth. TV series. Well, not a medical series exactly, with doctors and nurses having a quick cuddle behind the x-ray machine. Excuse me. More sort of exploring all the human story.
Derek, you're burbling it.
She said she'd even consider writing it with me. Four, please. I'll just tell her all about you.
You already have.
Only the dirty bits.
Like a novel.
I told her.
Fancy being blind.
I know.
Mind you, she'd have to be if she took a shine to you. Hi, Derek, you're coming off Pickham, can't you?
Good morning, Mrs. Longdon.
Oh, hello, love. I knew it was someone. Hey, look at this. Sell by the 11th, it says.
Today's only the 9th.
Yeah, I know. So I thought I'd just go and tell somebody.
Yeah, well, just on the day I turned up.
Woo! What's the verdict? Thanks very
Thank
much.
Thank you. Bloody made for you. Where were you?
Looking for matching gloves. I completely forgot about these buggers. So what?
what? We bought a hat.
Certainly did.
I look beautiful.
You do. Very beautiful.
I know. I told you. So did you fancy her then? And don't say who.
Of course I did.
Just checking. Nice to know you haven't lost all your faculties. Do you know what I'd like to do now? Go dancing.
Dana?
It's all right, I'm just dozing.
What are you playing at in there? How long does it take to run a frigging seam up?
As long as it'll take you to wash your mouth out with soap and water.
Bloody woman.
Not like you, this. Come on, put your finger here. Sir Derek Longdon, I don't know. One I haven't had the dubious privilege of meeting before.
You all want your bloody wages. I've got to get this lot to Bradford today, this afternoon. Henry's going spare.
Stitching time. Get it?
They're not bagged up, Joan. Pushing her head against a bloody brick wall.
Oh, you're welcome. Don't mention it. Our pleasure. Bradford, here you come.
It is.
What are you doing here, then?
This. You want a cup of tea or anything before I go? Sally!
She's gone out. Joanne wanted her to go to town with her for a bottom drawer.
Today? The wedding's weeks off. She promised she'd...
She'll be back in an hour or two, once she's bought every pair of coloured tights in town. Go on, I'm fine.
How's it going?
I can't do it, love. It's the only thing you're ever any good at. Not to worry. I hear naked bridesmaids are all the rage in California.
Come on your feet.
Oh, sewing's no easier standing up, you know.
Come here to the telly. If it's racing from Kempton Park, you can kick it in.
Derek, Bradford.
A few minutes will make no odds. Fantastic. One small step for Mrs. Longdon, a giant V sign for mankind.
It's not my own, though.
Enough. All in good time. You've got to learn to walk before you can walk.
Oh, Derek, love, give it a rest. Give me a rest.
And the walking? It was me that said enough.
Not the walking.
What then?
It's for me to say enough or not, as the case may be, or to hell with it, or whatever. Something has to be mine, love. My doing, my say-so. I don't mean the walking, love. I don't know what I mean. Go on, skedaddle. She'll be home soon.
I'll put you in bed then. Get your strength back.
Derek, Mr. Margolis.
Plenty of time.
You'll get stuck in the rush hour.
No problem.
You all right, mate?
You look like you could do with a doctor.
Sorry, private joke.
Interesting time to be weeding, Mum. Middle of winter.
Well, I like to catch them off guard.
You've got a thing about ironing boards, you and your son.
It's good for weeding, though, ain't it?
Kills the flowers quicker than the weeds do.
That's the only drawback.
Oh, bugger.
Can I help you pull your needle through again, Chuck?
Oh, sod that. I reckon the bridegroom's mother can go naked and all.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, I'd love one, please.
Are you sure? I'm having one.
Oh, all right, I will then, if you're having one.
Would you prefer tea?
I was wondering, could I just make a phone call?
If it's not engaged. Who do you want, love?
A Miss Aileen Armitage. It's, Harrogate. 0423-04-3-2. I think you have to pick the phone up first.
Oh, right.
With it being Harrogate.
Oh, I've forgotten the numbers now. That's it. I hope she appreciates all the trouble you're going to. Who is she anyway?
Hello.
Could I speak to Aileen Armitage, please?
Speaking. It's Diana Longdon here. Derek's wife.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Longdon.
Well, there's always Welsh rabbit. Or Welsh rabbit, as it says here. We're under new management.
What is it supposed to be? I've never known. Actually, it's neither, is it? Rare or rabbit. Or even Welsh, come to that. I think I'm burbling a bit, aren't I?
A cup of tea and a scone will do me.
Oh, I'll have the same. There's been a bit of a run on scones. We're under new management. There might only be the one left.
Ooh, oh, share.
I'll check any road.
Should have ordered cheese on toast. Driver really balmy.
So, what excuse did you give him?
Oh, he's used to me wanting to get out on my own for an hour or two once in a blue moon. With a neighbour, Helen, she picks me up. He panicked a bit about how I'd get to the toilet. Don't worry, I went before we came out.
That'd be a lot of help. Brakes off and straight into the gents.
You're easy to chat to. Easier than I thought.
You too.
Chatting's not what we're here for, though, is it?
Hey, announcement. Officer Boyd, Clegg. Boyd, Clegg. Passenger just arrived at Western. Hey, Boyd, customer service office.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Is this case on the shelf?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
It's bloody balmy, love. Honest to God, it's absolutely bloody balmy.
It'll be all right, Terry. I should do something on my own sometime. All I'll have to do is sit here. I'll try and do the best.
Let me at least come to King's Cross with you. Get you to the moors here, then I'll catch the next bag.
I don't need you, love. I can manage. Anyway, it'll be another ticket. Thought we were broke.
Sell my body in Soho.
You should sell my bugger while you're at it.
Forget the money. Do you want me to come?
No, go on. You're all right. The train will be going in a minute.
Are you sure?
Yeah. No, no. Come with me, love.
You won't be angry that you need me.
I do need you, love. I can always come back on my own. Cured overnight.
It's a deal. And a bloody chair.
Get the crash trolley ready.
Street, that one.
No.
Lift. It's all right, it's all right. She's coming through it.
God knows. She went into a convulsion and we had to abort the myelogram we were giving her. New one on me. Perhaps there was pressure on the brain. Who knows? What was that?
My fucking finger. You've just broken it.
Oh, I say, I'm most terribly sorry.
It happens.
Sister?
Hello, love.
Hello, sweetheart.
Go and have a smoke.
I don't want one.
You don't miss it much.
Oh, I don't know.
Well, go and have a beer then.
I don't want a beer either.
And screw one of the nurses.
Oh, all right.
Only the one, mind. You've a train to catch.
Sally isn't too keen on this, Dad.
Just bloody do it!
That's mine. I remember you buying me this when I was six. Shop at the pier.
The only chance we've got is when she's in hospital. I know there's more than one lot stashed away. We've got to get them before she gets a chance to love. I didn't buy it, I hired it.
I think the Stella can't bear it.
I'm going to do the airing cupboard.
Why now? Why this minute? Why do we have to look for them just now? If we do find her, he may swallow half the buggers or give them to her if she asks him to.
He worships her, you nutter.
That's why! Would you? Is that why you want them?
To chuck them away, I'd just chuck them away.
Then she's got no way out. If... you know, if it ever came to...
Right!
No, Sally. It's wrong.
Do this to Diana's and it breaks it. The thing about Diana, the main thing, from the day I met her, however sick she is, she's more alive than anyone I've ever known. She makes me more alive. Except you, I'm sorry to say.
Sounds like a judicious time to make a cup of tea.
You take sugar?
Don't you dare. It's my job.
Aileen.
Am I to assume a cup of tea isn't what you want at all?
I want... all I want is for her to be well and happy. And me too.
with her. What I don't want is to want you. I can cope, sort of, with most things, but I can't cope with this hating my bloody self.
Tell you what. How about if I slip into something loose?
Tell me about your ex-husband.
No, thanks. I'll slip into something loose.
I promise I won't talk any more about
that. Let me finish. I slip into something loose, like my CNA raincoat, and we go out for a walk, and you tell me everything about Diana. How's that?
Not much of a day, is it?
Oh, looks great to me.
Taxi! Yeah.
Hospital's given up on me.
I know.
Not before I gave up on them, though.
No.
They said I could try for the world record and go for one last one. The Hospital for Nervous Diseases.
What did you say?
Oh. Derek, that's us. 20 years' time.
Suits me, love.
One shoe might be all the rage one day. Like one earring. Three. Four. Five. Four. A week's convalescence, I might manage six.
Do you want to lie down a bit?
No. I want a Saturday morning treat for being good.
In that case, I'll lie down with you.
I tell you what, a run out in the car.
Ring Road? Salford Docks?
Aileen's.
Aileen... what's her name?
Armitage. Well, if she wants to do a play about me, she should meet me. Ring her and ask.
You don't go traipsing out.
Yes, I do. Anyway, a girl likes to size up the opposition. We'll laugh! Yes. Coming upstairs on our what?
On her own volition.
That is not what I said. No, I thought it wasn't.
Diana. Aileen, Diana.
Hello.
Hello.
Did you tell me Steve to prove it? Oh, yes. And a karate expert to boot.
Well, good for Sally. He gets better and better.
Is he still strong in the wine bar? Oh, well, yes. Oh, yes, but that was... it was Nottingham, but they had problems with planning or something. So it's Leicester again. Can you manage?
Just about. Your door needs a bit shaving off the bottom.
Don't we all? Derek will fix that for you while we go for our walk. He's a dab hand.
You need tools for a job like that.
Aileen's got tools. The only things her husband didn't take with him.
Well, how do you know?
Milk, Diana. Just a drop.
Jesus.
Yeah. Over to, a bit to the right.
Right.
Do you think you'll ever remarry? Stop! Stop! Right.
Do you think I'm ever going to cross here in one piece?
No.
Go.
Go. Don't suppose I will either.
Not later.
Well, very impressive.
Not from here, it's not. What's with that gap at the bottom?
What do you mean?
You've got a bit of an air vent, love.
It's an old house. You need a certain tolerance.
I tell you what, Aileen. Why don't you get Derek to shave another inch off, then he won't need to open it.
And you did say with Derek, you always get a bit more than you bargain for. Or in this case, a bit less. Right, Dan.
Diana, wakey, love, come on.
Can't have blackouts in Yorkshire, they charge you. Come on. Deep breath. Are you there?
God, is that the time?
Where's Nick?
Still in bed.
Not any longer, he isn't.
Dad!
Bloody church!
Dad.
10 minutes of this rain will do more good in half an hour than a fortnight of ordinary rain would do in a month.
It's not raining.
That's a part.
And finally, I'd just like to thank Jill and Myrna for helping with the delicate work on the bridesmaids' dresses, and my sister Sandra for not helping.
Right, right. You'll get that.
Thanks, Jace.
Cheers, Jace.
I don't think I can do this, love. It's her wedding, not mine.
You're still entitled to walk down the aisle.
Not if I don't get there till the bloody christening. Where did we say the starting line was?
Level with the first pew.
It's a bloody long way, Derek.
You don't have to do this, you know.
Come on. Sit down, that'll be it. And shut up. Please, love. I'm a bit like Rocket. I can't walk and talk at the same time.
Well done, Diana! Well done, Diana! trial.
So were you.
Can I wear it at my funeral? Say yes. Thanks.
What's this?
Aileen phoned.
How is she?
She's going to Blackpool for the weekend.
Yeah, writers' conference.
She said you'd been invited. I said no.
I have a previous engagement. Promised myself I'd defrost the fridge.
You go, love. Aileen will be there.
What are you saying?
I'm saying go to Blackpool and don't look so worried. That's a present for her. It's in Christmas wrapping. I know it's not Christmas. But then again, when is it ever?
Diana sent this for you.
What is it? Derek?
It's a brand new bikini she bought 6 years ago. And there's a letter.
Read it.
Dear Buggerlugs, I hope you have a swimming pool in the hotel. Randy Longdon bought it for me at Kendall's a couple of lifetimes ago. The girl in the shop said it would fit me like a second skin, which is why I want you to have it, to be my second skin. I'm discharging myself from the hospital as soon as I'm fit to travel. The consultant finally told me the only cure is to accept that there isn't one and stop fighting. Sorry if the writing's a bit wobbly, only I'm dictating it to a nurse from Sierra Leone and she's having trouble with her boyfriend. Now put your bikini on and let Derek chuck you in the deep end. Love, Diana. Why second skin?
I have a confession to make, love.
What does she mean, second skin?
We both have a confession to make, me and Diana.
Am I up to it?
I shouldn't think so, no. Diana and I have a little secret that you were never supposed to know.
She knew I'd be reading this.
What she wants is for you to fall in love with me.
I don't think I could love anyone more than I love her.
She knows that. So do I.
She won't die. I won't bloody let her.
Well, I think that's probably what she's banking on. What's banking on?
Oi! You! Bugger off! Buy your own bloody milk!
Bloody birds.
Beautiful day outside.
Not so good in here, though. I've got pins and needles in one of my legs and I can't tell which. You interfering with me, I hope.
Ta-da! It's cold as ice. I'll do you a hot one.
Cold? Felt boiling to me. Oh, love, can I have another bath as well? I'm sorry. Must be the umpteenth.
Who's counting? Okay, love. It's ready.
In a minute, love. Something hurts when I'm moving. I'm not sure what.
No matter. I just put the towels in the dryer. I think you're going to have a quiet word with Sally. She says she still only gets a really good night's kick when she's sleeping with Postman Pat. Remember my mother's first encounter with a duvet? She wasn't very impressed, was she? Having to undo all those buttons so she could get inside it. Joan said Friday'd be okay if you can wait. She said she can get hold of some tricell in a green, but not quite enough. Mrs. Longdon? Donna? No! No!
Mr. Derek Longdon.
She's upstairs. She's dead. Drowned. She has blackouts. Had blackouts.
Customs and Excise.
I'm sorry?
To inspect your VAT returns. You had a letter.
I'm sorry. Can you go, please? Sorry. I'm sorry.
With your accountant, are they?
I'm sorry.
Please. Speaking.
It's Diana Longdon here. Derek's wife.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Longdon. It's beautiful here, isn't it?
Hmm. We came up here when we were courting. The car got stuck in the snow. We had to tramp about 2 miles to a farmhouse in the valley. We kept ourselves going with thoughts of hot tea, bacon butties and a roaring log fire. When we got there, I was bitten by a dog and the farmer charged us for the tea.
Oh, Sally said to be back by about 6:30 unless we like soggy crackling.
All right. Come on, then.
Right.
Down a bit. Down a bit. Some lumps here.
Lumps? It's only called rocks.
Oh, rocks. Yes, it's rocks. Step up here.
Goodbye.
Bye.
I didn't think they had arranged marriages up here.
I don't think they do, Mum.
Bye, Mr. Ramjig.
Bye.
He's from India. He had a very nice chap.
What about?
I'm not really sure. Mrs. Gandhi's popped her clogs in India.
Yeah.
I used to like her, Dad. He got an Oscar.
Yeah. Not a bloody thing.
You don't have much luck with doors, do you, Derek?
He doesn't even try, does he? Sherbet lemon.